I am so glad to finally see something bother you.
Well, I can handle hearing your voice once, but when it's echoing, it's like a literal nightmare to me.
My voice echoing is a nightmare to you?
Well,
that's hurtful. I was going to share feelings with you today, and
dude, honesty is probably
because I feel like you're in a hurtful space.
Honesty is one of my biggest weaknesses.
Being honest?
Yeah.
Yeah, because you're a fucking liar.
What?
No. Is that what you're saying?
No, I'm saying like, I don't give a fuck what you think. No, I mean, but sorry, that was insensitive.
Yeah, I'm in a space right now, man.
Are you?
Very sensitive.
Are you introflecting? I think I made that one up.
Introspecting? Intro.
Introflection? I don't know. Whatever.
While we figure this out, what I'm doing.
Let's do it. Give me the.
We will we'll introduce episode 36. And yeah, I think that. No, I'm excited. I was telling Brian earlier that we got some good news that our video feed is now going to be up on Spotify and Anchor. So not only will you be able to get the video on YouTube, but you'll be able to get it on Spotify as well. Now, that's not for sure because I haven't tested it, obviously. I just got an email that said that they're going to publish it on Spotify.
But you have been in, you knew about this process.
Yes, I applied for this process to be on the beta program and to try it out and see.
And it's video podcast.
Correct. Video along with, because right now it's only audio on Anchor and iTunes and Spotify. But now through this beta program through Anchor, they're going to accept the video feed as well and take the video and publish that to Spotify as well. So that and Anchor. So that will be, I think.
Basically what you're saying is we're going to the Little Leagues.
We are going to the Little Leagues. We get our own uniforms.
Literally, dude. Yeah. Oh, man. Well, hopefully we can make something happen. It's definitely inspiring.
Well, it's exciting. You know, it's something new. I mean, obviously, you know, you get it to, when you put it on YouTube, you know, you got people that watch and listen on YouTube. And then now to be kind of that video format on Spotify and Anchor as well is just kind of opens us up to, I mean, you got to think of how many subscribers that, you know, might search something on Spotify. It just opens that realm for new audience and new people, you know, coming on board and checking things out. Now, it might not do anything for the YouTube numbers, but that's okay. At least, you know, if you have something on the Spotify side of things, you know, maybe that increases the exposure that we get. Now we just got to figure out what, you know, like good figure out shit to talk about.
I got lots of stuff to talk about.
Well, and I have questions to ask you.
Okay, you want high chew?
I had two high chew already. There, right, it's kind of a weak spot for me. They're good Japanese candies.
What do you want to talk about? All right, shoot, dude, go. Okay, come on. You're being weird today, man. Tell me.
No, I'm not being weird. What?
You won't tell me anything. You're telling me you got a lot, but you won't tell me anything.
Well, and I never know whether I should kind of
I'm not gonna be a dick. I swear.
You know, I never know if I should preface before I hit record with you, or if I should just kind of hit you with it so I can get your actual honest, true response of things. So most of the time, I like to just hit you with it, and then. That way I get more of an honest response instead of giving you time to think about what you think somebody wants to hear somebody say. Or
yeah, I don't really.
Anyway.
Thinking's not my thing, so go for it.
No, I know. But what I've been not struggling with, but what I think about often is whether or not I'm making the right decisions as far as career. You know, not career. Not, I shouldn't say. Well, no, career, life, work, all that stuff, right? Because you have an option. You know, once you're an adult, you obviously have to make money. And majority of us go to work and we work for somebody. A limited few work for themselves. Some people, you know, have a job, have two or three jobs. You know, but I've been both, right? I've worked for somebody. I've had the ability to work for somebody and kind of have that comfort of working for somebody, but still be, kind of doing, able to do my own thing under their umbrella. You know, with the first company that I worked for, you know, it was a construction company. So I kind of opened a whole South Sound division type thing. And so I was running that whole thing, and it made it so that, you know, I kind of could, hey, I want to do this job, you know, and they would say, okay, let's go after it. And we would go and get that job, or, you know, so I could kind of dictate how I wanted to run things. Mm-hmm. And then I had my own company, you know, so then you're the boss of everything. And the idea behind running your own company is the freedom, right? But what they don't tell you is that when you have your own company, it is 24/7. Your own company, you know, you don't have hours, because mm-hmm. especially if you have to make something or do something or produce something, you have to do, produce, make, whatever during normal business hours. And then when you're not during normal business hours, that's when you have to do the paperwork, the taxes, the business plan, the estimates, the, you know, ordering, the everything else, everything that goes along with the business. So it's not the freedom. Yes, it's there. But as far as, you know, working less hours, definitely not, you know, and now working for, you know, a giant corporation. So then it's a whole different thing. You know, you go from a small business to your own business that's small to a giant corporation. Then you're dealing with the hierarchy of things and, you know, your freedom to do things that you think are a good idea or try things out is gone. It's eliminated. You know, there's processes and things in place to, you know, you do this, there's this step and this step. And so it's a whole different thing. And I constantly go back and forth with, you know, this la-la dreamland of, man, if I did my own thing again, or if I started doing my own, had my own business and, you know, work, you know, I don't know. I keep going back and forth, and I always wonder if I'm doing the right thing for myself. And because I don't have there's no plan. And I guess my question to you is, do you have a plan? Like, have you, you know, a lot of people talk about a year plan, a 5-year plan, a 10-year plan. Do you base your work and your life on, do you have a plan? Like, is there an ultimate goal for you? I mean, because I know you have your rentals and you have your job. And so you're, you know, essentially you're working two jobs. But do you have an ultimate goal, an ultimate plan that says, okay, I got to this point, which is part of the plan, and now I can exit this? Or, I mean, do you work and live by that? Or are you just winging it?
No, I'm not winging it at all. This might fuck people up a little bit because, you know, there's a pretty, I don't know, I guess, I perceive myself as a little bit slow, you know,
like
a, you know, like
mover, slow mover.
No, like maybe I'm, you know, I might have a touch of something. I used to race dirt bikes. I did some boxing and, you know, I don't know. I feel like I have had some concussions. I don't know. You know, I'm not real. I just feel like you hear, everybody hears information, and I think it's the processing of, I process information easily. I process emotion easily. Things like that. I guess that's way off topic, but that's kind of how I deal with things. I just kind of like look at the, but sometimes I don't do, you know, sometimes I don't deal with things well, and typically I run when that's the case, whether it's relationships or whatever, right? Mistakes I've made or something. Which
I asked you about work, and you started talking about feelings.
Well, I'm talking about, I think that, well, so I have, and why I did that is because I have a base set of fundamental goals that I set a long time ago. And I know that sounds rich, but like literally I was like, okay, so the job I have is so that I can't get laid off, because I knew if I started buying houses, I'd be stretched out. And then I was able to surround myself with a lot of good mentors. You know, I think we've talked about the black swan, you know, some random dude I ran into at work told me about black swans, and I'm like, oh, what's that? And it's an unforeseen event, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, guess what just happened? a black swan.
Yeah.
And it's so interesting. And so I've always been a fairly pragmatic investor. So to answer your question, I mean, I don't know. You know, my grandpa's worked for the same company for like 70. I just, longevity, I was kind of thinking about that today. Yesterday was my 14-year anniversary, and I'm only 32. So, like, I think longevity, I don't know. I think, so my plan is to follow my heart. You know, my plan was to not have kids. My plan was, I wanted to buy more properties, but I got too mentally stressed out. And if I'm mentally stressed out, I don't really care. I more care about how I affect other people's lives. So if I'm all messed up in my head, I'm going to negatively affect people that I'm around every day. But if I'm in a positive mindset, then I can help the people I'm around grow, you know, and try to lead them the best I can.
So you don't have necessarily like...
I do. I mean, yeah. I mean, it's...
Do you have a point where you say, okay, if I get to this point, then I'm done here and I can solely focus on this one thing? I mean, because...
Well...
Your investment portfolio, it, for what, you know, for your age and all that kind of stuff is excellent.
I'm afraid of money.
But...
I'm afraid of it. I'm afraid of physical money.
I don't get it. Why? That you'll spend it or that you'll lose it?
No, I usually quadruple it, but... whether that's on the... Whether that's like... displayed income or not, that's a question when I'm not going to answer.
But I guess, I mean, that's just the, you know, because I, like I said, I keep going back and forth and it's...
Dude, I think that...
I don't know, I've never had a plan. Like, I didn't...
But I think you have that longevity. You...
Well, I didn't plan
gotta
on...
You got to hold on. What about... I don't know. I do things 5 years at a time, 10 years at a time. I set these. But also, so I don't think there's a plan. But you don't want to have a plan. You want to have a picture of who you are as a fundamental person. And so life's going to throw shit. You can't plan life. So life's just going to come at you. The only question you have to answer yourself is, am I dealing with things as a good person? Am I a good person? Does this fit my being, my morals? Like you said, obviously your moral integrity is being challenged. And so that's, you're going, hey, this is, obviously you're doing the right thing. You're questioning that. Now, does that require something as drastic as a career change? That's subjective. I don't know anything about, I don't know much about you other than you're one of my best friends. You know, like I don't know much about you. So your risk tolerance, that's, but I would say that you're doing just fine, Tyler.
No, I know, but you know, like what, I guess what I'm getting at is like, you know, if you talk to me last month, I was like, oh man, I need to kind of focus more on this over here and get the ball rolling on this. And then you talk to me this month and it's like, no, I'm in it. You know, I'm going to keep marching this same path and just keep going. Next month, it might be back to this over here. And I just feel like I bounce.
Well, you're going to probably go through what's never... more difficult. So like when I do that too, but just like also I know that you can't quit. You got to keep. The reason I'm at where I'm at is because I just, the amount of times I wanted to sell, the amount of times I could have cashed in and made it, you know what I mean? You just keep holding on, keep holding on, keep holding on and doing the right thing. And, you know, as long as, like, the way I look at it, I don't care what my time, it, like, I feel guilty when I'm sleeping. So, like, as long as my time is spent productively, like, either at work or something, working on a car, working on a house, some building value, whether I'm getting paid for it or doing it for somebody else or whatever, as long as we're creating value. But I'm not a big change guy. Like as long as everything's going smooth, I'm pretty into it. Like, but then, you know, I'll learn to adapt whatever situation I'm in to something that's going to better suit me. Now, not a whole lot of growth going on there in a professional sector like that. I'm kind of just cruising, right? You're in a different ballgame. So to answer your question, I don't know. That's up to you. But I would make sure that no matter what, have a couple options. Like legit fucking options, not shit that like... I mean, being an entrepreneur is one thing. But like I would say if you want to go professional anything, start doing it every day. If you want to do something, be something, whatever, do a little. Even if you did 10 minutes of it every day.
No, and I get that part of it. I mean, I understand the concept and I understand what you mean by that. But I guess the moral of the whole thing is just the fact that, you know, I often wonder if you go through the same things that I'm doing, if everybody else goes through the same things that I'm doing.
That's what I'm saying. I'm
as
like,
far as questioning.
I'm quadruple you, though. Think about it. You're asking me, you know, I could retire or whatever. Or I could go bail to some island. You know, I'm you know, thank God for the market and, you know, whatever happened. You know, the politicians or whoever raised house prices. Jesus, I don't know. Thank you.
Inflation,
whatever. So to answer your question, like, just keep holding on. I'm holding on. Like, I'm like, I could do a lot of shit, but I'm like, what I think about is, what do I need to do to, because it gets, you know, things like black swans can really mess you up. You know, and then and it's not necessarily an issue, but it's a lot of paper. You got all this, there's all this paperwork to get through and all this. You got to do this, freaking do that, and da 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 da. To use things like equity and things, you know, like, you know what I mean?
No, I know that.
But you don't want to sell. So like I said, I don't want to sell anything. I don't want to, if I get fired or something, I mean, that's kind of what I figure. I figure if I get fired, then it's like, that's like the sign. I got to start taking.
So you don't even have, like, I mean, there's not a point where even down the road 10 years from now or...
Oh, dude, I don't think I'm going to... Dude, I'm living it fucking a quarter mile at a time, bro. All
right, Vin.
Serious. Like, fuck, I don't know if I'm going to live to next week. Do you?
Well, no. Nobody does.
The fuck would I think? I mean, every day, dude. That's what I think. I don't think 10 years ahead. I think I'm going to be... In 10 years, I think I'm going to be... Oh, it's going to be stupid. I'm going to be on a yacht or something.
I know that, but I mean, at least have a ballpark, like somewhere you want, like a point where you want to be, you know, that long-term point where you want to be. And if you got to that point,
I want
to
love myself, dude. I swear to God, I don't care what the fuck I'm doing, but as long as I'm mentally okay. I don't think that anything's going to help me be okay up here. It doesn't matter what I'm doing, whether I'm working for somebody, like I'm grateful that. If I don't get up at 4:30 in the morning, somebody yells at me. Multiple people. Like, I get, like, if I'm not up, man, this shit is hitting the fan.
Well, I guess that's just, I mean, this did nothing for me.
What?
Talking to you.
Because you're searching for answers, and I gave you the most direct answer.
I guess I'm not searching for answers. I guess I just want to make sure that everybody else...
There's no smoking gun. You're right. Yeah, everybody's having the same struggle, but you just have to follow your gut. My gut tells me keep holding on. Maybe when my parents die. I don't know. I don't know what's fucking keep me here. But, you know, doing shit with you, my parents are really important to me.
Well, no, I know. And a lot of times people make a decision from a big life event, you know, whether it be a death or...
I figure you're a good life coach, manager. So I'll just bring you with me. That's kind of my... To be honest, that's kind of my plan. I should probably fill you in on that one.
Yeah.
By the way.
But no, I mean, like...
But kind of seriously.
COVID, I mean, obviously you can see from the numbers that are in the news, you know, about how many people are quitting their jobs and people that have realized that... whether they were furloughed or they were working from home and now they're getting called back into the office and they're just like, man, that's not what I want to do. And they're making that change. They're making that jump. You know, I mean, it's something, you know, this big life event, whereas we didn't have necessarily, we weren't impacted very much, you know, because of the COVID, with the job and stuff like that, that we have. So we weren't impacted from doing what we normally do on a day-to-day basis. And so, but a lot of these people that do work from home or got sent to work from home and they enjoyed, you know, spending more time with their families, or they enjoyed, you know, having that option of being able to do the work, you know, kind of some in the morning, maybe spending an afternoon with their kids and doing some in the evening and being able to break that up and just a whole different life plan or lifestyle. And then it's created now they're getting called back into an office or something where they're having to go back in, sit down at a desk, work for 8 hours straight, do that whole deal, do the commute, sit in traffic. They've realized that, hey man, this isn't for me, and I don't want to.
Well,
do this.
It costs,
now they're making that change.
Costs money almost with the amount of, like, Man, I had Stitch fax something over his phone. A fax. How cool is that?
Yeah. Huh. Were you blown away?
I just was like, why are we even faxing? I had to get another app to, like, really?
Well, there's one app that can fax email.
Well, then you got to scan, whatever.
Scan, whatever you want. There's one. You can find one app for that.
But anyway, so, yeah, dude, I don't know, man. Sorry for fucking your whole day up, man.
Well, you didn't screw my day up. You just didn't give me the answer. Which I guess I wasn't necessarily looking for an answer.
I think you'll find the answer.
I'm never looking for the answer. I guess the whole point of it was I just wanted to see if, you know, me questioning whether or not I'm on the right path or I'm doing the right thing is still.
What about being grateful that you have a killer job? I mean, you are like internationally famous and shit.
Yeah, I probably don't think about that very often.
I get overwhelmed with gratitude. Dude, that's why
I don't stop to.
People freak out. I'm like, dude, hey.
You know, well, I mean, I should probably stop and be thankful for where I'm at, what I have, and all that kind of stuff. But I don't think that
you have to.
Ever take the time to.
I
think about the next step. What's the next step? What's the next thing? What do I do next? You know, that kind of thing. And or how do I get to be the very best at what I'm doing now? How do I get to that point?
By loving yourself, by fucking finding peace with what you're doing, by using things like gratitude, bro. I'm serious.
Self-talk and meditation and gratitude and all that stuff.
Dude, it's for real. It's helped me a lot, man. It's helped me with my relationships. It's helped me with, it's important to accept every, it's just, you gotta accept it. And if you can't accept it, you got to let it go.
So what's your routine?
My routine?
Mm-hmm. Because some people have a gratitude journal. You say you do it in the car. So what is your routine for your gratitude? Do you drive to work in silence and just say your thank yous?
Mm-mm. No, sometimes I just, I don't know. Like sometimes I forget how, dude, bro, like this is crazy. I'll just like walk in. I'll just see something that'll make me think of something like. I don't know, like, I went to a friend's house the other day, and it's a really nice house, but it ain't my house, and I'm like, whoa, dude, like, and I'm over here bitching, because it takes me 3 hours to fucking mop, you know, and I'm like, damn, dude, I'm grateful to have space to utilize to do shit in, you know what I mean, I live around a bunch of old people, dude.
What does that mean?
Well, I'm just grateful. I don't know. I'm just saying, like, to start, you know, I have 10 fingers and 10 toes. I'm grateful for that. I'm grateful for my home. I'm grateful for the fucking ribs I ate last night. I'm grateful for the truck I drove to work today. What?
Do you really?
Yeah.
In the mornings?
Dude, I get over fucking, not in the mornings, not on my way to work. I'm not super grateful. I don't cry, but I get like happy. I'm like, whoa, I get kind of tripped out. Like I almost like trip out. I almost feel like sometimes like I'm on like literally mushrooms. I'm like, whoa, because it's such a euphoric feeling to realize how amazing life is. Dude, what if you had a disability? What if you couldn't? I'll be running like a goof or whatever and just be like, wow, dude, how cool. I get to just haul fucking ass. Even though I'm just running in the middle of nowhere for no reason, I can. Swear to God. I don't know, dude.
No, that's good. I mean, if that helps you in your outlook.
How could it not?
Yeah. No, you're right. I mean, you know, yeah, because it could be, there's a lot of things that could be worse.
Yeah, dude, I got nothing to complain about.
Yeah. Well,
You look like Gerard Butler, dude. Jason Statham, I mean.
And you look like John Hamm.
I look like John Hamm, I guess.
That's what.
He's an older dude, too, so that's cool, whatever. So, yeah, man, I would just say meditate, dude.
Okay.
But seriously, man, hey, think about it, dude.
No, and I've tried that. I mean, I.
Wow.
I've tried, you know, maybe I didn't put a lot of effort into it, but I did that one time, I think.
Well, I've had to, you know, I'm not, I've had to leave anger behind.
So you're never angry anymore?
No, I'm still angry.
Okay.
Occasionally. But I'm trying to, I'm learning to not get so angry.
Gotcha.
Because I like freedom. And sometimes I get angry. So that would definitely be one of my downfalls. But that's why I'm doing it, to try to help me stay. Because sometimes when people are inconsiderate or do weird stuff, it upsets me. And I am just learning to be not so reactive, because I find that keeping a calm, cool composure is more effective.
It's definitely more effective.
Well, yeah, I mean, I've kind of was, but yeah, I had to learn that shit. I wasn't ever really taught to fucking be calm and cool. I was yelling, scaring shit out of everybody was fucking the way to go. That's your best. Quick as fastest.
Yeah.
But like, or like letting people fuck you over until you get to the point where you're like, enough is enough. And it's like, now I'm like realizing, no, I'm going to set my boundaries out of the gate. And if you violate what we're going to talk about in a very calm manner, that's that. You know, it's like, hey, I can tolerate this a little bit, or this is a no-go zone. And that's just what it is. And then you have to follow your heart and your moral fiber. That comes back to that moral fiber, that loving yourself, that core being, right? Because you're happy and you're doing what you want, whether it's employment, whatever. You have to figure that out for yourself. But I don't recommend self-employment unless you're really prepared for it. Give it 2 weeks. Take 2 weeks off. That's what happened to me. I was like, I'll be self-employed. Fuck that, 2 weeks off because of COVID. I didn't get up before fucking 1 p.m. one day. Dude, I had zero self-discipline. I was like, holy shit, what a shit bag.
Well, that is definitely something that people can learn about themselves, you know, that you do learn about them. When you have to rely solely on yourself, it's a whole different thing, you know, because like you said, you know, nobody's going to wake you up. Nobody's going to call you. Nobody's going to,
and nobody gives a fuck. No, nobody cares.
Responsible.
Nah.
For getting to the job.
People actually prefer to watch you fail, I think.
Oh, for sure.
Well, actually, that's like, isn't that like the whole point of theater, is like the rise and fall of every fucking everything? Like, people want to watch you go. They want to watch you rise just to watch you fall.
Yeah.
Which is fine.
Yeah. So it's better just to stay failure the whole time.
I think I like failure. I think I've stayed in failure. I think that's one of my, like, if I'm not failing at something, I feel weird. I'm like, ooh, shit, life's too good, you know? It's weird. Something's fucked up. I'm going to lose a foot.
If things are too good, then I'm always looking.
Yeah, dude, I get freaked out. Yeah. When shit's, I'm like, whoa, where is it, you know? Like, what the fuck?
If it's not right there, it's coming. Something will come to bring you back down, to make you realize that you're not.
That's why you got
to
be humble.
That awesome.
Because if you're humble, you won't stumble, remember?
Okay. Let's end with that. If you're humble.
I just roll with the exotic shit, dude.
If you're humble, you don't stumble. All right.
But you can't talk about it.
Okay. I won't talk about it. All right. Thanks for watching episode 36.
Did you have your fingers crossed behind your back?
I did.